What up, YouTube fans? This is Zubi Masters returning to my Let's Play of Immortal Fenyx Rising.
Happen to be Aphrodite?
Why, yes, I am. Pleasure to humbly make your acquaintance.
Fenyx, sorry, I'm just such a fan. You're responsible for some of the most epic love stories of all time. I have to admit, I wasn't expecting a tree, but even in your, arboreal state, you're beautiful.
Oh, that's sweet of you to say, but the only mirror I gaze into these days reflects the happy smiles of the creatures I help. Oh, if only I could travel to those most in need. But, alas, my roots keep me anchored here.
So that's why Typhon did this to you. So you can't use your beauty to move ships or inspire bravery in battle against him.
Me? Start a war? I don't know where you get such outlandish ideas. True beauty is found in acts of service. True love is the giving of yourself to others. The name Aphrodite should have stood for those things all along.
She did not just say that.
I am reformed now. My old essence locked away in a vault, wedged under my largest root, which is for the best.
Maybe I could get that essence back for you. I'm going to need allies to go up against Typhon.
We have the hungry to think about.
You said you need to free yourself from your roots. To feed the hungry, of course. Well, my roots were as a pretty bad farmer. So I know how to hurt plants. Salt. It shrivels them up.
Oh, would that work? But of course my roots are not ordinary. They're primal. Powerful.
So we'll need, mythical salt water? Oh! Oh! This is in the prophecy! A pearl in rough seas! You were a pearl born from rough seas! The salty seafoam from your birth!
Yes! What an inspired proposal! But I couldn't possibly trouble a stranger to recreate the conditions of my birth.
What if a stranger asked to be troubled?
If a stranger asked to be troubled, then I suppose I wouldn't really be troubling them at all. Here's how to conjure seafoam from my birthplace.
I already know all about this. Mom loved this story. Grandpappy Uranus threw a pearl into the sea. The sea churned into foam, and Aphrodite rose up out of it.
A pearl, Grandpappy? I'm not sure that's how it...
That's definitely the story.
Okay. I'm sure that's how it went, down.
Got it. Knock a pearl into the ocean really hard. That sounds simple enough.
Oh, thank you, Fenyx. I'll be serving fresh apples to the less fortunate across the Golden Isle in no time.
Well, this is weirder than the time Demeter turned that kid into a lizard. Aphrodite, sweet and charitable. No more mischief.
Isn't that what you were aiming for when you married her off to Hephaestus against her will?
Hey now, it wasn't. I mean, she knew I was doing it for her own good.
Yeah. Well, it seems strange, huh? Hey, Fenyx! Can you autograph a stone for me later?
Locked all the Cyclopes away with the other Titans, huh?
Yes. He was afraid they'd overthrow him. There was a prophecy.
Bored. Grandpappy made the right call. Those things are an eyesore. Get it?
The birth of Aphrodite is a gruesome tale.
Nothing gruesome about it. Grandpappy Uranus and my deadbeat dad, Cronos, had a battle so great it severed heaven from earth.
That's not all that was severed. During his surprise attack, Cronos descended on Uranus.
When Earth was severed from heaven, there was a great earthquake that knocked a pearl loose from its oyster.
Hang on, there was no...
The pearl flew from its oyster on land, and Uranus caught it and flung it out to sea with such a force that it caused the frothy foam to bubble. From the sea foam, Aphrodite rose, full grown, beautiful as that same pearl.
I can't take this anymore. Zeus, Gaia lied to you about how Aphrodite was born.
Oh yeah? Then tell me how it really happened.
And Kronos, they fought.
You can't be serious.
Fell into the sea.
That's...
because Kronos cut off his...
You're sick, Prometheus! Do not talk to me!
With the sea foam secure... Phoenix resolved to return to Aphrodite with the key to her freedom and the vault. Aphrodite's palace, the most majestic sight on the Golden Isle skyline.
I don't know if it's the most majestic. There's one mountain in particular I think is pretty regal.
Oh!
returned, you sweet creature. Do you have the seafoam?
Right here.
Oh, aren't you good? Please, take my blessing for all your hard work. Now quick, pour the foam on my roots. The sooner I can move, the sooner I can expand my apple care.
Did it work?
Coming out of the foam, I was so fabulous. No, there's too many cuddly creatures that need my help. It keeps me awake at night, just seeing their little beaks and bright eyes. And those noses, those quivering wet noses.
Happened?
Typhon must not like you, though I couldn't possibly imagine why. Whenever anyone defies him, he sends one of his raids, and that raid delegates responsibility, as raids tend to do, to shades.
So the warrior that just appeared wasn't really Achilles?
Goodness, no! The true Achilles is far more dashing.
Oh, you're telling me.
He's hiding in a lair nearby. Until he's defeated, his shades will reappear on this part of the island.
Is there ever any good news?
Well, the sea foam worked and I'm able to move my roots. One of them was actually blocking Achilles' lair. I can't help but the other three raids, though. Heracles, Atalanta, and Odysseus. Oh, you know what they say. Bad things come in fours.
No one says that.
No one says that!
Tough crowd.
What about the root blocking your essence? It's just that some people I care about have been turned into stone. So I'm quite keen to...
Nope. No. For some reason, that root is still firmly in place. Thank you for your concern. But what matters is I can start delivering apples. All the animals will be fed in no time. Let's get to it. Thank you kindly for all your help. Many happy returns.
But I... That was strange.
I can't keep standing idly by. Sorry, I mean busily preparing anymore. You have to bring Aphrodite back to her beautiful snarky self before I go crazy.
By the gods, where did you come from?
Behind you? Doesn't matter. Don't worry about me. Focus on finding another way to shrivel that root.
So what? Saltier, more mythical water? Actually, wait. What about Aphrodite's tears? Didn't she cry at the death of Adonis? They'd be salty and powerful.
You really know your stories, kid. Her tears just might work. If you put them directly on the root, blocking off her essence. Now, where did Typhon hide them? You should search the vaults of Tartarus nearby. There are three crystallized tears.
I actually found those already.
With all three tears collected, Fenyx set off to shrivel Aphrodite's most stubborn root and open her vault.
Yes?
Too easy. Forget it.
Thank you.
hoping to shrivel the root to unblock the vault. Fenyx sprinkled the tears.
No! No! Adonis, my love! Why does my mind dwell on you? What's happening to me?
Oops! I'd better go find Aphrodite.
Aphrodite really loved Adonis. And I married her off to Hephaestus.
Yes. Adonis meant the world to her.
I let that boar kill him.
You did what?
I mean, I didn't kill him, but I didn't try to save him either. I didn't listen to Aphrodite.
Aphrodite, please, just tell me what's wrong.
Well, I appreciate that you were trying to help me. There was really no need to trouble yourself.
I just thought if we could move the root, I could get you.
I can move the root any time I want! Well, since you watered my roots with the sea foam, that is. So, thank you. But there is no need to concern yourself with my essence.
Wait. I've been putting up with all this, the tears, the horrific niceness, for no reason? You're undead to me.
Hermes, all my pettiest jealousies and all my most self-absorbed beliefs are locked away. Why would I ever want to be reunited with them?
Sure, you weren't the most charitable person, but that's not everything. Remember all the fun we had gossiping about the other gods? Making fun of the ugly Sasha's hair or wears to parties?
That bastard Sash made her look like a shriveled carrot! No! It was all time wasted! I should have been more! I never measured up!
What in Hades are you talking about, never measured up? By whose standard?
What's she talking about?
I can't imagine.
It's no use. She won't hear reason.
Try insulting some other gods.
No, it would only be fun for me. Acts of charity are all good and necessary, but not from Aphrodite. Her spice made the world interesting. She added a zing to things, you know?
She literally changed the world. I mean, she started the Trojan War. And also, she could be named the most beautiful.
That's it!
I don't know if we have time to start a war, Hermes.
No! We'll bring her the prize her vanity won her. Something she wanted so much, she let the world go to war for it. If she sees it, maybe she'll want her old zing back.
The Apple of Discord!
The Apple of Discord!
I'll find it as soon as I can.
Good. She's boring right now. I can't make one remark about what Persephone is doing with her hair before she starts prattling on about the needy. I miss the old Aphrodite.
Gods are so 50-50. Thank the gods you're here to be decisive.
Yeah.
farmer's boy. Always doing whatever Aphrodite told him to. Like shooting Helen with his arrow to fulfill her bargain with Paris of Troy.
I wonder if Fenyx will test the power of an arrow on the Helen statue. Once Eros struck her with his arrow, she was powerless to do anything but leave her husband, Menelaus of Sparta, for Paris.
Thank you.
Did you know this rooster was once the great Electrion?
Helios's annoying bird that screeches every time the sun comes up?
The very one. Knock him dead, Phoenix! That dumb bird is the last thing I want to hear after partying with Dionysus.
Well, that's it for this video. Hope you'll like it and stay tuned.